The speed of light is 299,792,458 meters per second, which is a very long number to write. It takes up a lot of paper, and it takes me a long time to type it into my calculator. For most calculations, I don't really need this degree of precision. It's rare for me to do a calculation with more than 3 or 4 significant figures. If I wanted to round this value to 4 significant figures, it would be 299,800,000 meters per second. That's still quite long to write out, and now it's really easy to make a mistake about the number of zeros to write. Scientific notation is a much quicker way to write very large numbers. In scientific notation, the speed of light written to 4 sig figs is 2.998 times 10 to the 8th meters per second. If I need to write it with 3 sig figs, it's 3.00 times 10 to the 8 meters per second. This notation is much more compact and easier to read. We can also use scientific notation to abbreviate very small numbers. For example, the mass of a proton is 0.000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000000 solving atomic mass. You'd waste so much paper. It's so much faster and easier to write this number in scientific notation. With 3 sig figs, it's 1.67 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. Notice that for very large numbers, the exponent on the 10 is positive, and for very small numbers, the exponent on the 10 is negative. How do we convert these very long numbers into the much shorter scientific notation? Let's start with the speed of light example. The first step is to find where the decimal point is. When a number is written as an integer like this, there is an understood decimal at the end. So let's go ahead and put that in. The next step is to move the decimal point until there's only one non-zero digit to the left of the decimal. Each time you move a decimal point, you are changing the number by a factor of 10, so we need to keep track of the number of moves. Let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We moved the decimal to the left 8 times. That's equivalent to dividing the number by 10 to the 8th. To make sure we don't actually change the value of the number, we have to multiply by 10 to the 8th. Here's another way to think of it. Let's use a smaller number like 45,000 so we can see the pattern more easily. We'll put in the decimal at the end of 45,000. 45,000 is the same as 45,000 times 10 to the 0. 10 to the 0 equals 1, so you can multiply any number by 10 to the 0, and you won't change that number. I'm putting that in so you can see it's not a big deal to have that times 10 at the end. Times 10 to the 0 is a way to say the decimal hasn't changed position at all. If we move the decimal one place to the left, we now have 4,500.0. That's a different number. 4,500 is much less than 45,000. 10 times less. By moving the decimal point one step to the left, we divided 45,000 by 10. So to cancel the effect of moving the decimal, we need to multiply by 10. So it's like 4,500.0 times 10 to the 0 times 10 to the 1 equals 4,500.0 times 10 to the 1. Let's move the decimal again. 450.00 times 10 to the 1 times 10 to the 1 equals 450.00 times 10 squared. Each time we move the decimal, we need to multiply by another 10. Count up all the tens, and you'll see that to write 45,000 in scientific notation, we moved the decimal point 4 times. So we need to multiply by 10 4 times. We get 4.5 times 10 to the 4th. We do something very similar when we use scientific notation for very small numbers. Let's use the human red blood cell as an example. It's 8 micrometers in diameter. That's 0.000008 meters. Once again, we really don't want to have to write down all those zeros. Let's rewrite it in scientific notation. Step 1, find the decimal point. This one is here already. Step 2, move the decimal point until there is one non-zero digit to the left of the decimal. Don't forget to count how many steps you move the decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Notice we're moving the decimal point to the right. Each time we move the decimal point to the right, that's the same as multiplying the number by 10. That means we're going to have to divide the final number by 10 for every step that decimal point takes to the right. Step 3, write the number and multiply by 10 raised to the negative of the number of steps. So in this case, we get 8 times 10 to the negative 6. Are you already familiar with negative powers of 10? Let's review this idea. When we move the decimal to the right, we need to undo that by dividing by 10. We can write that as 10 to the negative 1, which is the same as 1 over 10. If we move the decimal point twice, that means we need to divide by 10 twice. We can think of that as 1 over 10 times 1 over 10, which is the same as 1 over 10 squared, which is the same as 10 to the negative 2. Let's continue in this way until we get to 10 to the negative 6. How about if we want to go in the other direction? What if we started with a number in scientific notation and we want to expand it? For example, the approximate age of the Earth is 4.543 times 10 to the 9th years. To get rid of that 10 to the 9th, we need to move the decimal point to the right. Remember, moving the decimal point to the right is the same as multiplying by 10. So each time you move the decimal to the right, take away one of those tens on the right. 45.43 times 10 to the 8th, 454.3 times 10 to the 7th, 4,543 times 10 to the 6th, 45,430 times 10 to the 5th, 454,300 times 10 to the 4th, 4,543,000 times 10 to the 3rd, 45,430,000 times 10 squared, 454,300,000 times 10, finally, 4,543,000,000. A quick word about vocabulary. We say that in scientific notation, a number is written as a product between a coefficient and a power of 10. Here you can see on the left is the coefficient. It's always a number between 1 and 10. The coefficient is multiplied by a power of 10, and it can be either a positive or a negative power of 10. 10 is the base, and this is the exponent. Recognizing each of these parts is important when it comes to adding and subtracting numbers in scientific notation. Now let's turn to calculations using scientific notation. First, we'll look at the rules for adding and subtracting, and then we'll look at examples for multiplying and dividing. Add the mass of a proton and the mass of a neutron. 1.673 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms plus 1.675 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. These numbers have the same base and exponent, so all we need to do is add together the coefficients, so we get 3.348 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. The coefficient is still between 1 and 10, so there's no need to change the exponent on the right. Let's look at an example where the exponent would change. Find the mass of 10 protons. We can add 1.673 times 10 to the negative 27 10 times. That's the same as multiplying the coefficient by 10. We get 16.73 times 10 to the negative 27. We'll move the decimal point one step to the left, and then we can rewrite this as 1.673 times 10 to the negative 26. What do we do when the exponents are different? We'll need to manipulate the numbers so they have the same exponents. This involves moving the decimal point. For example, if we do this calculation, 8.43 times 10 to the 3rd plus 9.765 times 10 to the 6th, we need to shift the decimal point on one of these numbers so the exponents match. Let's move the decimal point on 9.765 times 10 to the 6th so we have 10 to the 3rd. To do that, we move the decimal to the right three places. 9,765 times 10 to the 3rd. Now that these two numbers have the same base and exponents, we can just add their coefficients. 8.43 plus 9,765 equals 9,773.43, and don't forget the times 10 to the 3rd. Move the decimal point to get back to scientific notation. 9.77343 times 10 to the 6. Notice that there were only two decimal places in 8.43, so we'll round to two decimal places in our final answer, 9.77 times 10 to the 6. If you need a refresher on significant figures, check out our video on that subject. The same rules apply if you are subtracting. As long as the base and exponent of the two numbers are the same, you can just do the operation on the coefficients. For example, 3.1415 times 10 to the 4th minus 2.71828 times 10 to the 4th equals 0.42322 times 10 to the 4th. Rewrite in scientific notation by moving the decimal point one place to the right. 4.2322 times 10 to the 3rd, and we already have the correct number of sig figs. To multiply two numbers in scientific notation, you multiply their coefficients and add their exponents. Keep the same number of significant digits as the number with the fewest significant digits. For example, 5.56 times 10 to the 3rd times 2.124 times 10 to the 5th equals 11.80944 times 10 to the 8th. Round to three sig figs, 11.8 times 10 to the 8th. Again, if you need a refresher on sig figs, we have a video all about those rules. To divide two numbers in scientific notation, you divide the coefficients and subtract the exponents. Round your final answer to the number of significant figures in the coefficient with the smallest number of significant figures. 4.5 times 10 to the 7th divided by 7.82 times 10 to the 9th equals 0.5754457 times 10 to the negative 2. Round to two sig figs. 5.8 times 10 to the negative 3rd. If you're working with scientific notation on a calculator, make sure you know how to enter in these values correctly. It depends on the calculator. There may be a 10 to the X button, or there may be a button that says E. These mean the same thing. If you want to enter in 5 times 10 to the 3rd, you would type in 5, then the multiply button, then 10 to the X button, then 3. Or you would type in 5, then the E button, then 3. Either way, you'll get 5,000. Did you know there are lots of ways you can help us continue our work here at Socratica? First, please watch our videos all the way to the end and hit like. Share our videos with your friends and on Twitter or Facebook or Google+, wherever you like to share things. If you're not subscribed, subscribe now. You'll be the first to hear about our newest videos. And finally, if you would like to support Socratica with money, well, you can do that on Patreon. Patreon lets you support your favorite channels for as little as $1 a month. Our patrons are such a huge help, I can't even begin to tell you. Here's one more thing you can do. We're always looking for more topics to cover at Socratica. So please let us know in the comments which videos you would really like to see next. Thanks for watching Socratica.